Hello everybody, welcome to yet another Planet Coaster video on my channel. We'll be working on Selva, Azteca today. Well, it's not like I work on anything else other than this, but as you can see straight away, we're putting down a dark ride. This is a motionless dark ride, and yeah, that's what we will be up to in this video. So it's part 12 now, and I'm really surprised with how quick this series has gone, to be honest. Felt like we were starting it not that long ago, and we're probably about halfway there now. Yeah, I'm really happy with how it's going, and in this video we don't get too much done, to be honest, and that's really frustrating because I worked on this for about 5 hours in total. And yeah, it's been quite difficult editing this, trying to put out the footage. You may see quite a few jumps in the time lapse in this because of that reason. And yeah, we'll be working on a dark ride. Obviously, I'm not too great at dark rides. I don't really build them very often. In fact, this is my first ever trackless dark ride that I've done. Yeah, so that's what we'll be doing in this video. There's quite a few motion-based trackless dark rides. I don't want to say motionless because that sounds like it doesn't move at all, which it clearly does, as you can see. But I've done quite a lot of these at theme parks. I think they're really good rides. They're pretty modern. They use some very modern systems. The way they work is usually like a visual line that there's like a camera that follows it or something like that. But the ride's almost programmed to go its own places, and it doesn't follow a track, but I believe that there's wheels underneath it. And there's also different pistons which can allow the seats to move and roll side to side and stuff like that. So I do try to use that a little bit in this ride. But a few that I've ridden, for example, the Ratatouille ride at Disneyland Paris at Walt Disney Studios. I don't remember that too much because I was just in a rush because the park was closing and we wanted to get one last ride on Rock and Roll Coaster, and I really enjoyed that. But yeah, Ratatouille, I remember it being quite interactive. They had some 4D stuff like water effects, and yeah, it's really cool. A couple of others I've been on, the Emperor of the Penguin, I think that's what it's called, at SeaWorld Orlando, and that one's really short, unfortunately, but it's still quite a good ride. And they use a lot of screens in that, I've noticed. And to be fair, they use a lot of screens in Ratatouille. I think Ratatouille is actually a 3D one. And I'm not sure how the screens will be going because I'm not that great at like tech. I'm not that much. I think Theme Park LB is a bit more into that than I am. So I don't get any screens in this video, but he may look at doing that in future episodes. I'm not really sure how it's going. But you can see that he's made screens for like queue times, and he's edited like the on-ride photos and stuff like that, so he's a bit better at that kind of stuff than I am. But we do get probably half of this done. I don't finish the interior of it because I sort of lost quite a few ideas. I didn't have the greatest imagination when doing this, but I think the end result is decent for somebody who's not that confident at building dark rides. But I just wanted to have a variety in the lineup for this park. You can see that we've got two great coasters already, and we're planning to build a few more coasters. There's also some decent looking dark rides which are highly themed in my opinion. So that's the Condor, the Hus Condor and the Hus Topspin. So I've put quite a lot of effort into building those, and I want to put effort into this as well. And it took me ages to do, and a feature that we work on later, I'll talk about this a bit later on, but the ride stops halfway through. You can see a little bit of terrain, and yeah, so I was making like a little show on board where the ride stops halfway around, and a display sequence, which is the first time I've ever used one of those before. So I think it looks decent, but now you can see me building this snake thing, and it's quite cool how the ride goes around this. Specifically the way, because I want to have the train facing, I want to have the car facing this as it rotates around it, so you can see a little bit how it circles around it and then goes, it overlaps the track. And in real life, these rides do this. Symbolica at Efteling, the trackless dark ride, and that, you know, overlaps itself quite a lot because these are trackless, obviously, so they can go back and forth, and it's just like a road that they're free to drive on, almost. I think that's a decent way of explaining how they work. But the rotation system for this in the game is really horrible, to be honest. I don't know if I just don't get it at all, but you can see me here messing with it slightly, maybe not very much, but basically the arrows point which way the car faces. They may also tilt up or down depending on whether the seat's going to tilt up or down, and that's what the rides do for real. But for me, I don't like, I press the button to change one in one place and then it changes it in the other part of the ride. And yeah, I had a lot of issues with trying to get this ride to work, but I want to be realistic and use rides like ride systems that are used in real life. And for example, well, I've already given you a lot of examples, and that's what I was going on about. But Symbolica Efteling is the other trackless dark ride that I've not gone into detail about, and in my opinion, that's the best. It's one of the best dark rides in the world, probably. Yeah, it's just so detailed. It's also got three separate tracks. So basically the storyline for that is that you're in a palace, and yeah, the queue line as well as a pre-show before it, a pre-show before a dark ride. There's actually one of those at Phantom Manor at Disneyland Paris. But it shows so much effort that Efteling are putting in to have a pre-show on a dark ride. And yeah, so there's a really cool feature with the stairs. I'm not going to spoil it because when I saw it, it really surprised me, and I was like, wow, how have they done that? But basically it's about a tour of this palace, and there's different tours you can do, like the toy tour. So they show all the toys that they've got and stuff like that, because it's sort of like the children going around the palace showing you like different things, and some of it was trophies, I'm not really sure. I don't know which one I went on. I only went on the ride once, so obviously you're gonna have to go on it three times if you want to see everything, but that's the point. There's so much to see, and it's also interactive. There's some buttons on the front seat which you can press, and I think it affects what the car actually does, so the programming for it is really clever. So it works in real time, and literally every ride experience is going to be different depending on what buttons you press. I'm not too sure with how it works, so you can tell I'm not going into too much detail about it, but it's really good. And now, yeah, this is what I was talking about. I don't really know what to call this. It's like a pre-show, but it's not a pre-show because it's at the end of the ride. But you can see there that the car just stops for about 20 seconds. And yeah, I'm just doing a bit of terraforming here, putting some rocks in. And I wanted just to create a little scene. And this is almost like the grand finale of the ride. You can see this boulder moving back and forth. And yeah, I had a few issues with this. But yeah, it's the first display sequence I've done. And very soon you should see me put that in, I think. I'm just waiting until we get onto the display sequence. But yeah, you can see some different animatronics going on. I had a storyline in mind for this scene. You can see that the this little ramp is supported by some little wooden beams, and you can see that they will snap. And my idea was that there's some archaeologists, as you can see going in now, they're trying to get a jewel or something. So you can see that there's a green emerald going in now. So the archaeologists are trying to get that, so they're hacking at it. And then accidentally they chop the supports down for this ramp. I'm not sure how well it will actually be portrayed in real, but that's the storyline that I was going for. So I set up the sequence so that it looks like they're trying to get the jewel, then they knock down the supports for the ramp, and because the ramp has lost support, then this boulder comes rolling down, which sets off an explosion. There's some water effects, and then somehow it makes a chain of a chain of fire alongside a rope, like a dynamite, and then you can see that trail going along, and then there's an explosion, and I'm quite proud of it, to be honest. I think it could be so much better. Theme Park LB also did a display sequence on the Vulcan coaster. That's the name for it. I don't know if we talked about that. But there's a wooden gravity grip coaster, and it will be called Vulcan because it's a theme to volcanoes. So I think that's a cool name. But yeah, this display sequence is pretty complicated. You can see there's a lot of stuff going on in it. And for a bit here, you can see different fires going in. And I think first I'll put a rope down. Yeah, and then there's lots of different little cannons for the fire to come out of. And programming this was really annoying because when I selected them all together and then added them into the display sequence, they weren't in order, and it took me a while to realise that. So then I had to go back and change it, and basically you type in like a different time, so how long from the start you want each one to go off. But there you can see a massive chain of fire going along this rope, which then reaches a box with dynamite in. And to the right of your screen now, you can see me setting off all these so that it follows a chain of it. And yeah, you can roughly see the end result there, and that's basically all we do with that. I hope that it looks good on ride. But anyway, we're now doing something very different. You might have seen towards the start of the video, I did a little bit of work on the queue, which is under this now. And yeah, this Empire Tenochtitlan, having a look at some artistic photos of it, because obviously it wouldn't be actual photos, so some artist impressions. They had absolutely tons of these Mayan pyramids, and I think quite a lot of you will know what they look like, and you certainly will after this. So I'm going to build a pyramid which acts as the facade, so it's like a temple, and then the ride is inside the temple. And I could have done it better, but like, you know, I'm not amazing at the game, so I'm happy for what it is. But what I'm happy about, like at the end result, is the fact that the way that it covers it up, but it doesn't look huge. So it's quite hard to explain, but I built this temple, and it looks like basically I only built half of it, because you know that's what facades are like in theme parks. You only build the front, what the guests can see, because it would be a waste of money to put effort into something that's not going to be seen. So you can see me here just working only on the front of it, really. A little bit around the side, because I wanted it to look like it was 3D. So I wanted it to look like it was a full-scale pyramid. And yeah, you can see different colours going in. Some of it I wanted to be walls, some of it I wanted it to be walkways. You can see these handrails along the side, and that was actually inspired from the Indiana Jones and the Temple of Peril at Disneyland Paris. You walk up a queue, you walk up the path like on the stairs that way, and there's a little snake that goes alongside it, and I was thinking about that a bit. I'm not sure if it looks amazing, but there it is. And well, this video is actually going very quick. We're almost at the end now, so I hope you've all enjoyed. And yeah, remember to leave a like, leave a comment as well. I've not really asked for much suggestions of what you want me to build, so just ask for suggestions of what you want to see in the future for the series. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Remember, check out Theme Park LB for part 13. I will leave the link in the description as always, and yeah, have a good one. Goodbye.